So if you see the screen now, we must see these are the all outstanding pole vaulters of international levels and our national level also. You see this boy is the Armand Duplantis. Now who is recently in the 2020 created a world record with a height of 6.18. Then followed by she is Yelena Shnabeva. She is also holding the current world record of 5.06 meters in women's pole vaults. This is S. Shiva, who is our current national champion in pole vaults with a performance of 5.30 meters. Now, of course, she is Surekha, current record holder in women's section with a height of 4.15 meters. And of course, you can see this is our young boy who is having the current record in the junior session, that is Prashant Singh Kanaya of 5.05 meters. And you can see the Bubka is here, who is the most consistency pole vaulter in the world, of who was broken 35 times of his personal record and created world record 35 times. And he was holding that time 6.14 meter was his personal best. Of course, now the Armand Duplantis is so surprised. His record now it is 6.18 meters. Okay. Now, if you go a little bit about the introduction of pole vault. So, pole vault is the most demanding events in track and field. It is most demanding and most complex events as far as the technicality is concerned. And also, it is a very thrilling event for both the athlete as well as the spectators. So, already I explained you the world record for the man is 6.18 meters. In the name of Armand Duplantis, and the women's section is 5.05 meter in the name of Yelena Shnabeva. The Indian record for man is 5.30 meters, 30 meter in the name of S. Shiva, and for women by Mrs. Surekha, B. Surekha is 4.15 meter, and the junior section that Prashant Singh of 0.5 meters. And so pole vault, if you see, the pole vault require speed, strength, coordination, kinesthetic awareness, and gymnastic ability. Beyond of this, skill vaulting requires a unique type of courage, because you need also along with lot of psychological qualities also, like willpower, then mental toughness, because courage, because see, at the height of, you have to fall from a height of almost all 6 meter and above. So you need how much courage. So in total, the pole vault requires speed, strength, coordination, kinesthetic awareness, gymnastics in all the events. But here it is specially the kinesthetic awareness and the gymnastic ability it demands. So now if you see the how the height is progressing, if you see right from wooden era to bamboo era to metal pole era to the fiberglass pole, as your the pole material has been changed, so the performance has been drastically changed. Right from it has started from 10 feet to now it reached to the 20 feet and above. If you see the top, but now almost 6.18 meter. So I must say this is the most ability is why this drastic has changed take place, because the change of the material, remember the pole materials from the wooden to bamboo, then to the metal, then to the fiberglass poles. Because why we are going to get much more benefit in fiberglass pole, so I'll explain in my next slide when I compare the rigid and fiberglass pole. So little bit about coaching philosophy of pole vaulting. Little about coaching philosophy of pole vaulting. See, as a pole vault coach, you must develop and recruit athletes a wide range of skills. So possessing wide range of technical skills, physical ability. Then while selecting a potential pole vaulter, also look for the athlete who possess or willing to develop speed, upper body strength, gymnastic ability. Already I explained. Early. A coach should first train pole vaulters to be good, all-round athletes. The complex technique, the technique is so complex. The pole vault demands the coach to teach pole part whole methods. In the other word, you have to, when you teach the pole vault, you have to taught the whole things of the pole vault. The athlete should know what is the whole things about pole vault. Then you can learn the technique through repetition portion of the vault drills, essential to part by part. So finally, the partial skills should be integrated in a complete pole vault. But above all, since it is a very risky event, you need a safety. You should have, being a coach or being an athlete, you should focus on the safety before doing or before you start off your session. You should focus on the safety point. You must ensure that during the around the pole vault arena, no other things should be there. No obstacles should be there. Then you must see the landing pit. The pit should be in a good condition. You must see, check your poles. Pole condition should be good. There should not be any crack. And all these things, and also vaulting box also you must see. Then your run-up area should check up. Everything should be all right. So as for the safe facility, safe equipment, safe training technique and continuous supervision are mandatory for the pole vault. Always emphasize safety first, since it is a very risky event. So if you see the whole session of technical analyze, that means if you see the pole vault total session, you can start from the approach to the plant to the take-up penetration, then rock back, stretch turn and bar clear. These are the whole session we have to deal with. If you see the as a whole, you can deal with the, from the approach to the plant to the takeoff to the bar penetration, rock back, stretch and bar clear. In generally, if you see all the jumping phase, they are in the four phases. It is approach, takeoff, flight and landing. But approach, in the pole vault situation, approach, then in the takeoff, it is plant and takeoff. Then in the during flight phase, you have to do rock backs, stretch turn, bar, then flight phase. Then of course it is bar clearance and landing. So in the approach and plant phase, the vaulters accelerate to maximum control speed and smooth position the pole for the why our aim in the approach run. So you have to develop fast, control approach velocity, because you need velocity, you need speed to that. Whatever the approach you have developed, the velocity that has to be loaded into the pole. Until you say faster approach velocity, then you are not able to load maximum energy into the pole. So you need, that's why you need approach for the main purpose of the approach and plant phase. Vaulters accelerate maximum control speed and smoothly position of the pole before the takeoff. In the takeoff and penetration phase, energy from the approach is transported to the pole. In the rock back stretch turn phase, energy stored in the pole, then utilized to rise the vaulters up. This is assisted by additional muscle action. The bar clearance phase is the completion of the vault and the start of preparation for the safe landing. Now we'll go by part by part. So before start of the approach run, you should have a grip and you should have a very good grip and carry position. So the objective is to, the grip and carry position is to hold the pole correctly for the approach run and plant. So technical characteristic is to hand should have both, you have a two grip. One is the right hand top grip, it should be top of the pole, and lower arm should be the bottom side of the pole. So the hand grip between both the poles has to be slightly shoulder width apart, or maybe one arm distance, or if you say it is 45 to 70 centimeter. So then the hands are shoulder width apart, right hand is higher on the pole, both arms are bent, and the right hand is close to the hip. So these are the basic requirement. So as a pole vault coach, you should teach the athlete. They should know what are the best, how to hold and how to place, where to place. So these are the basic requirement before start of your approach. So as already explained, both arms bent, the right hand is close to the hip. This is the yardstick. Right hand has to be close to the right hip, and tips of the pole is above the head height. Elbow of the left arms point to the left side. Upper body keep upright. So these are the points you should have before start of the going for the approach. You should have you should have a proper hand grip, pole grips, and so you have to proper pole grip and place your pole exactly the place where you want to have got the maximum benefits. So now approach runs. Next is the approach run, the first stage. Approach run also they are divided into three parts. It is approach run, entry, that is entry phase, acceleration phase, and preparation for plant and takeoff. So the main aim of the approach run is to develop maximum control speed and preparing for a effective run. That means यहाँ पे हमें क्या है ड्यूरिंग अप्रोच रन व्हाट इज अवर एम एम इज टू डेवलप मैक्सिमम ऑप्टिमम कंट्रोल स्पीड क्योंकि व्हाट द स्पीड वी हैव डेवलप दैट वी हैव टू बी कन्वर्टेड फॉर ए प्लांट एंड टेक ऑफ एंड फर्दर फॉर सो दैट यू कैन एबल टू कंप्लीटली व्हाट एवर द स्पीड यू आर डेवलप दैट हैज टू बी लोडेड इनटू द पोल बाय डूइंग ए टेक्निक सो दैट फेज बाय फेज एक्सप्लेन नाउ. So now this is the aim of the approach. So how will start the approach? Approach run can start either with the feet parallel or with one foot to the rear of the others. But so for the beginners, I suggest you should start your approach run by with feet parallel together, so that then when you become advanced, then you can change either from the feet parallel together or from astride position, that is one foot to the rear of others, or from jog or little bit jogging to start your approach. Then second point you have to see, the pole tip should be begin high and gradually lowered through the approach. That means the tips of the pole at the beginning you should keep high, should well above your head, so that your pole and your body should be close while running, it won't be obstructed. Okay, then as you progress, then the pole has to be lowered in between your approach, in between the center of the approach run, that should be come to the parallel, and gradually it should be lowered through the approach run from the top to the bottom. So it should be gradually lowered, not all of a sudden, not should not be any jar. It is smooth lowering of your pole. Then approach run, the athlete feel tall with good running technique and upright body position when approaching the vaulting box. So the gradually increase the speed to the box. Our aim, what is the aim? Our aim, like in a sprint at 100 meter, we have to achieve as early as possible to our maximum speed. But here in any jump situation, even in the pole vaults, our top speed should be at the time of takeoff. So that's why you should gradually increase your speed to the vaulting box. Gradually increase in speed to the box. The length of the approach run should be between 35 meters to 45 meters, or between 18 to 22 strides. For the beginners also, it should be around 10 to 12 strides also. No, because as they progress, they can increase their approach run. Because why? Until then, you will not increase your approach run in the latter stage. You're not going to you are not able to try your maximum speeds. So maximum almost speeds come around, you know, is 30 to 45 meters. So our approach run should be when elite should be around 30 to 45 meters, depend upon the level of your athletes. So for little bit, let me explain this area a little bit in Hindi. Approach run jab aap karte ho, you have to focus. Approach run generally three part होता है. One is एक तो entry phase हो गया, Second is the acceleration phase, where you can develop your maximum speed, you can accelerate, then move to pressure plant. ठीक है, उसके बाद आपने क्या करने का, तो बिगिनिंग में आपने फिट पैरेलल में जाने का है. सो योर स्टार्टिंग पोजीशन ऑफ योर अप्रोच शुड बी फिट शुड बी पैरेलल टू द और वन स्ट्राइड पोजीशन बिटवीन एक वेक्स एक लेग का एक फुट का अदर फुट रहना चाहिए. द टिप्स जो पोल का टिप्स आपके हेड का ऊपर होना चाहिए, हेड अबव द हेड, आपको सीट का हेड का ऊपर होना चाहिए. एंड आपने पोल को धीरे से ग्रेजुअली लोअरिंग करना, नॉट लाइक फ्रॉम द टॉप, फ्रॉम द ऊपर से नीचे तक सडनली नहीं लोअरिंग करना, इट शुड बी ग्रेजुअली, धीरे धीरे आपको लोअरिंग करते जाना एज यू प्रोग्रेस इन द अप्रोच रन. सो दैट शुड बी स्मूथ, आपको लगे स्मूथ लोअरिंग ऑफ द पोल्स. तो कोच मस्ट सी हिज लोअरिंग, जो बोल को नीचे लाते हैं कैसे स्मूथ एंड प्रोग्रेस लोअरिंग द पोल मस्ट सी. Then athlete feel tall होना चाहिए, body should be tall with good running technique, upright position, body upright and when approaching to the bolting box. Then gradually you have to increase speed को धीरे धीरे बढ़ाते जाओ, so that जब आप box के पास पहुंचोगे you will have your top speed. Oh, generally जो आपकी approach और length होता है almost 18 to जो elite group 18 to 22 stride between 35 to 45 meters. For the beginners you can go maybe around 10 to 12 stride or 12 to 15 stride, depend upon your the level of your athlete and the training age. So as you develop speed and strength, you can increase to your approach run distance. It's clear. The name move to the plant phase. So next plant phase. So plant, this is the most important in the as for the pole vault. This plant and takeoff, if you see, is the most important phase because vaulting performance depend upon these two plant. And if you don't have a good plant and takeoff, that means you are not able to give your maximum performance. So the objective is the plant. Uska ye uddesh kya hai plant ka, to the pole preparation for the takeoff with minimize the loss of it. That means ye plant phase mein you have to preparation for the takeoff and while minimize the loss of speed. As you know, though, our speeds count a lot. After the horizontal speed, it should be minimized loose. Hona chahiye, not during this pole plant phase and takeoff phase. The next, then, what are the technical attributes you have to know? The tips of the pole is lowered gradually and smoothly in the last three side of the approach. जो आपके लास्ट थ्री साइड ऑफ द अप्रोच बिफोर टेक ऑफ, उस टाइम आपकी पोल हैज टू बी स्मूथली ग्रेजुअली फर्दर लोअरिंग डाउन. देन नेक्स्ट द प्लांट कम्स, द जो प्लांट स्टार्ट व्हेन यू व्हेन एट द टाइम ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट ऑफ योर लेफ्ट फुट ऑफ योर पेनल्टी मैट, ऑफ योर पेनल्टी मैट साइड. दैट मीन्स लास्ट स्ट्राइड, दिस इज द सेकेंड स्ट्राइड बिफोर टेक ऑफ. Takeoff stride and second stride. This is the last go to one stride before takeoff is known as a penalty mat. The second stride of takeoff is known as penalty mat. So when you landed, when your foot is going landed or left foot, jo aapke baaye foot land ground mein land kar raha, that time you start your penalty, your pole plant start. So what happen? Yahan pe aapne kya karna hai? The pole has to be pushed forward. So from your just see, the pole has to be push forward. The pole has to be pushed forward. Then the right arm is raised quickly. The hand push close to the right head at the contact of the right foot. That means when your right foot contact, see the point. Your right arms, top and grip should be closer to the above your head. So it has to be gradually. You have to up. This is the point. When your left foot of your penultimate side contact of the ground, you start your plant. Okay, then by pushing the pole forward, that means the pole has to be pushed forward and upward. So you start first pushing the pole forward as soon as your left foot of your penultimate side strides contact on the ground. Then as again from when you move from left to right, still one stride is there for the take off. When move from left to right, I mean, jab aapne baaye se daine pair ko jaoge, that time the pole has to be pushed upward, and it should be at least come near to the close to your head, your right ear and the head. It should be close to the head. So this is this point. This is the most important point you should note, and his coach should. This is the fundamental. You should fundamental, because this picture is downloaded from the approved from IAAF World Athletics lecture. What used to lecture in the world. So this is the you see many action, many think in many picture in the YouTube. But this is the fundamental. First should be you start your plant when your left foot of your penultimate strides contact on the ground by pushing the pole forward. Then when you move from left to right, your top grip, your right hand grip should be move upward, and it should be at least come close to the right above your head and close to your head. Okay, these are the two important points. Ye jo dono points aapko ye plant phase mein dhyan rakhna. Then body is upright and with the shoulders square to the bone. That means your body should be still upright, and aapke shoulder bind nahi hona chahiye. It should be direction to the. It should be square to the vaulting box ki taraf hona chahiye. Dono shoulder, neither left. They should not be twisting. Okay, so that when you do the next action, then take off, so that you can able to load, you will charge, you can able to load your completely energy whatever you have developed to the pole. That is in the form of kinetic energy. We can show in the next slide is that when I'll little bit speak about the physics of pole vault. This that is also lit by me, because pole vault, it is more related to the biomechanics, more technique. Because why ever we are still in the not improving much, because this is also one of the factor. Pole is one factor, lack of equipment is one factor, mat is equal factor. Because it is a very, if you are buying one mat, is nowadays costing about 8 to 10 lakhs. So you should, until unless you have pole vault mats in all districts, then sufficient number of poles, a athlete need 8 to 10 poles. Right from training to reach to the competition, they need, it needs 10 to 10 pole. Everybody says our performance is not going, but I'll tell you, this is the easy event where you can easily improve your performance. Suddenly you can improve your performance, subject you should have sufficient number of poles, sufficient number of infrastructure facility. Because yahi ek event hai jo hum aapko madad karta hai, because ek pole ke जरिए आप कूदते हो, यू आर क्रॉस बार विद द हेल्प ऑफ ए पोल. नो अदर इवेंट्स इन एथलेटिक्स. दिस इज द ओनली इवेंट वेर द रूल ऑल्सो परमिट गेट एडवांटेज, बिकॉज पोल बाय प्लांटिंग ए पोल ओनली विद द पोल ओनली यू कैन क्रॉस विद द हेल्प ऑफ पोल यू कैन क्रॉस द क्रॉस बार. सो आई विल टेल यू दिस इज द ओनली athletic events, so you can get the result. But the problem is in India, it is a lack of many. So it is very easy to say pole vault is very poor, very low. We are not reaching to the 6.1 meter is world record. We are still in 5.30 meter. Women section still we are 506 in the world record. We are in around 4.5 15. But you must. You must consider what facility we are giving to them. We have talent in India. There is no talent that as far as pole vault is concerned. Now few academic has come up also. They are training little bit. That's why the performance has come little up. So now if you have government is give more facility, more number of poles provided at grassroots. Just see if at the last I'll show you one video how this armament. Duplantis at the age of 6 to how he has progressed his from his world record from age of 6 to reach to 6.18. just see the facility, see the condition, See the competition also. They in Europe, there is age group competition. Competition, pole vault competition. Seven, at the age of 7 years. So we have a world record for the 7 years age group also. 12 years age group also. That means pole vault, they have started very early because they have poles. They have very small poles, number of poles for training poles. It is the length of the pole is very small, maybe around 3 meters. 3 meter, 3.10, 350. You should have this kind of pole and soft nature of pole so that at the child also you can start the drills. You can start the drills, not like specializers, but you can teach in the pole vaulting the skills during the multi event stage or even in the multi event stage, or you can promote for the kids for this to attract for this event. Now, as the left who begins to drive the takeoff, and then after that, as the your move from now, you have from the now, this is the plan not completed, and further you have to move. As you move, as your left takeoff foot should ground above the ground, then this is the another point. Your right hand top hand grip should be fully extended. There should not be any because we have to clear here a good planting angles, planting and takeoff angles. Why? I'll explain the next slide. So now this is the from the penultimate side of the left to move your pole forward. Pole has to be pushed forward. Then during your penultimate side of your right foot contact on the ground, pole should be up to the head level height. Pole height should be up to the head level height. And before and when you are about to start going for the takeoff, your pole should be well extended ahead of your head. Hand should be fully extended. Leg and hand should be fully extended. So these are the three key points. These three points should be the coaches and the young athletes should focus, should know. So the plant and takeoff, this area should be thorough. So next is about the takeoff phase. Now this is the takeoff phase. So now the takeoff phase, what are the purpose is to, now your purpose is whatever the approach energy you have developed, whatever the speed in the form of kinetic energy you have developed during approach run. Aapki approach run ka time mein jo bhi energy aapne develop kiye, speed develop kiye, that is known as the kinetic energy. And that has to be developed, that has to be now to put into the pole, maximum energy to the pole. So now the takeoff foot plant has to be very active and should be flat. It should be entire sole of the foot. Now the technical point should know, your foot plant has to be very active and should be on the entire sole of the pole. That means you can sole. Then body is completely stretched with the right arm fully extended. The body is completely stretched and with the right arm is fully extended. Then upper right hand is directly above and in front of the takeoff. So your upper arm should be directly directly off your takeoff foot and slightly ahead of your takeoff foot. This is the number one, the point number one. So it should be, so the this should remember. The upper right hand is directly above in front of the takeoff foot. Then thigh of the free leg swings actively forward. The thigh of the swing leg should be actively forward. Now we are moving from the takeoff to, we are moving the next is the rock back phase. We are moving now. Transfer energy completely into the pole. So what are the points you have to be see here? That means the vaulter frees the takeoff position. Whatever the takeoff position you have leaving the ground, that takeoff position has to be freeze. This takeoff position has to be freeze. Okay, by freeze means you have to hold that takeoff position for a while. Then the hang on the top hand and stay behind the pole. So you have to hand on the top hand and stay behind the pole. That means after rock take off, you have to go for rock back. Before rock back also three. That means hang, swing and rock back. Now first you have to hang, then swing, then come to the rock back. So try to, by hanging, try to keep away from the pole. Don't be in cross the pole. You have to be, try to keep away from the pole by pushing your both arms forward and upward. Pushing the both arms forward, and this has to be forward and upward. No bend. There should not be any bend here. So the long pendulum are created around both the shoulder and hip. So you have to create a long pendulum between the shoulder and the hip axis. So there should be a long pendulum. You must create a long pendulum. Okay. So that this, why what is the advantage? Then you will come to know the physique of where I'll take to. This is, you make a, that means in other sense, aapne pura ek seedha rakhne, hang karke body ko straight seedha rakhna aur body ko pole ki taraf allow jane ke allow nahi karne ka, by both the arms, dono haath, left arm and right arm ko fully, you have to fully extended forward and upward. Left arm is pushed forward and upward, already explained to you. The left arm has to be pushed forward and upward, or right arm already, it is extended already, then right arm fully extended. So this is the mechanism. This has to be hang by making a long pendulum, by keeping your right arm straight, and then second point, you have to observe, left arm should be pushing forward and upward. Both arms should be extended. No, there should not be any flex. This is the key point. You have to see. Then right arm fully extended. Then to achieve maximum bend on the pole. This is the rock bend. Next is the rock bend. That is the extension of the, that was the extension of the takeoff. You can call it is a hang and swing phase. Now from the hang and swing phase, will move. It is a part of in the rock back phase. After takeoff penetration, there is a part of rock back phase. So now the next will move to so rock, this is the move to the rock back phase. Yes. Okay. So the rock back, though, so aim of rock back is the, to achieve maximum pole bend, by bending maximum pole, so that you can store the energy in the pole. So it is make, so when you can have a maximum rock back, when you have in the L shape, when you come to the English L shape, when you will be the L shape, that means your pole is maximum bend and you are in the rock back. That your main aim is to achieve. Now the pole bend start from, it has started from penetration, slight bit pole start, initiation of pole bend, start right from takeoff penetration slow, then move to hang, then move to swing, then move to rock back. It's the final, where the pole bend maximum, around 90, pole bend around 90 degrees. Here the pole bend is maximum. So, ye jo rock back hai, iska main purpose kya hai, aapne, by doing a rock back technique, pole ko jyada se jyada bend karne ka. But this is the stage. After that, you will not get a chance. Because, iske baad kya, pole start now strengthening. Pole, apne aap phir seedhe hone jayega. It has start straightening. Okay. So, keep on starting. You can keep on uprighting slow to the pole. Because after maximum bend, now the pole is ready to give maximum energy back. That energy will give back by when the pole become straight. Okay, start on straightening, then you give the maximum energy. So to achieve maximum pole bends, store energy, the position of the body lies in the store energy. So then technical characteristic, what both legs are bent and drawn to the chest. You just see, that's the two. This I will show you. This is Edmund Duplantis, and this is our young boy of, this is Prashant. This is Prashant Kanhaiya. If you see, yeah, boy, if you see the rock bag, almost all near, almost 90% is as parallel to, as compared to the old class ball vaulter. So that means these boys' technique, fundamental technique is clear, is good as far as IWF or World Athletics model, the technical model. See, if you see the rock bag, because I got the one sketch of junior when he created the junior Indian record 505.05. See the rock bag. It is a very good, close. It is close to the, our world leader. This is world record holder, Armand Duplantis. So this boy, that means his coach, now he is training under one Devendra Singh. He's a former pole vaulters, now working railways and doing good fundamental. He is developed because he's developed basic concept. I know him. He has developed the fundamental concept and he is now technically also he is very sound and training. Now this boy is training under him. He is our KHELO INDIA Academy, Pole Vault Academy. This boy is in Delhi. So Devendra Singh, that former pole holder, is training now. He's, so I hope he has fundamental concept he has developed. So I hope in future, this boy has very future, subject to he must get some exact number of poles for his training and training, because he has all facilities, but he should have, as the, he develop the speed, develop the strength, develop the technique, so that he need the to chase switchover from, now his grip height is only 465. So he has to increase his grip height by increasing the next, go move to the next higher pole. Now the back is roughly parallel to the ground. Back should be roughly parallel to the ground when you are in the rock back position. Aapko jo back pura ground ka parallel hona chahiye. You can see making a English alphabet L. A letter of L. Then both are extended still here. Both are still extended. Oh no, there is no bend. What? So, key point is here, the key point is you must see the key point. That means movement, action, will approach, take off, and then after coming back to the brakes, the motor. No movement you have to do. Any, no extra movement. If you're pulling your arms back in the rock back position, pole is bent, the further pole will be further bent. So definitely it will not help to move up. It will not lift as fast as possible to do the other action. Then back is roughly parallel to the grounds. Okay. Now next is the stretch and turn phase. So this is the next end. Turn phase. That means this will start. Now the body is moved from L to I. The body is moved from L to I. I still, the pole is not straight. It's going to be straight. Okay. Then when the pole is about to straight, then right arm is extended. Still the right arm is extended. Left arm bends with a little bit bend. Left arm has to start bending because now you have to do the pull. You have to start the pull and turn. So instead of right, only up to little bit bend your left elbow. Then hip pass close to the pole. It is about to pass close to the pole. Left hand is bent. But see the right hand. Right hand still, the top hand grip is still, it is extended. No action. If you know, but in our Indian, most of the pole world here doing the mistake. From here, they're going to move to the both hands. They will by doing the pulling, pulling action by bending both arms. No, you can pull your lower arms, not on the top arm. Top arm should be still straight. Turn is commenced with the pull of the both arms. So now, when you about to, now the after that, when you about to turn, when the body is fully extended, fully is inverted, upside down, then now. Up to turn, you start that when you start the turn, that means that is the time you can start turn the commence. Then you start by pulling. Now after the that you can pull, start your pull in both arms. Both the body turns to the to face the bar. Now body is turned to facing the bar. Bar ki taraf dekhne ka hai. So that is the point. So these are the points to observe. So these are the main points you should observe. If you observe and if you do the practice, that means definitely as a whole you can improve your performance. Now the bar clearance and landing phase. So to gain maximum height after the release of the pole and clear the bar. So bar is crossed in a two. There are the two type of bar clearance. That means either in a bent position, this is the position, or in a arch, the arch position, and then in a bending, in a V shape. This is arch V shape. Okay. Now body is straight after crossing the bar. Body then roll over, and body straight and roll over and landing. Landing on the back only. Landing on the back, not in the neck. So landing on the whole back. Whole back should be landing. So okay. Now next move to the little bit about the. I have explained though about the technique. What are the points you have to focus? Already I have explained. So keep focusing those points. Now little bit about you. About the biomechanics. I'll go little bit fast because we have to cover the many things now. So generally, if you analyze the biomechanical aspect, that means these are three divided into three parts, three parameters: velocity at the takeoff, angle at the takeoff, height of center gravity at the takeoff. That means velocity and the angle, the takeoff velocity and the takeoff angle, the both the result of action of the all athlete prior to the during takeoff. Because these two action has to be decided. You have to perform before the takeoff because you need a takeoff speed. You need a which angle you have to do the takeoff. So this has to be before leaving the going for takeoff. So the takeoff is the major important in all. So that's why takeoff phase is the most important. Not in pole vault. It is on the all jumps because you have to fix your flight path the way the path is traveled. Okay. Then there are additional factor also affecting the height of the flight in the pole vault. The then the most important of there are the transfer of energy into the pole. That means there are additional factor affecting the pole vault height flight of the board. That means the another factor is transfer of energy. What energy transfer mean? What of the speed or the kinetic energy you have developed during the takeoff? During the energy during the approach run and takeoff, then that same energy has to be loaded into the pole. Now the pole will give you the return the energy from the pole after takeoff is provided, provided you. Then so it will lift you the body up. Then further you can additional lift you can have from your shoulder and your arms from the body. So the pole vault is also a transfer of momentum in which the athlete store kinetic energy in the pole and then use this potential energy to propel his. That means the kinetic energy which you have been stored transfer into the pole, and that energy in the form of potential energy will lift you to propel your body. The pole is the vaulter's energy bank. That means like a bank. The amount of money you will deposit in the bank, same amount of money you will draw from the bank. So it is like only the amount of energy you will deposit into the pole, same amount of energy give you back. So in this, so try to load maximum energy. How? By improving by your speed, your technique, your pole plantation and takeoff technique, and position of your both the arms and position of your takeoff position at the arms or takeoff position at the time of takeoff. So these are the point parameters how will completely load the energy into the pole. So that into the pole. That means when good you develop a good through the running rhythm, you can develop a good approach run rhythm. Then do develop the speeds. then have a nice plant and take off. Try to create a higher planting angle by extending the arms, right? Your top arm should be fully extended right from the leg, your from foot to the foot to the top arm should be fully extended, and make a good penetration by keeping away from from the pole, by making have a good penetration. By that means deep, you must have a forward and upward. When you take off, should be have a very good forward and upward. You should be attack forward. That means you should have a good penetration. That means you deep go inside, go move inside towards the pit. So you'll have a good penetration. The other is sorry. I'm a little bit disturbed. Sorry. Now it is a double pen. The pole vault is a double pendulum system.
So please go for presentation mode, sir. Slideshow at the bottom.
Yeah, presentation mode. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Now, okay?
Yes, sir. Fine.
So the pole. So it is a double. So the little bit you should know about the little bit about the physics. That means pole is a double pendulum system. One first pendulum is the pole which rotates from the base of the support in the box to the point where the pole border top hand job from the niche se pendulum start from the where the pole tips fix in the box, landed in the box, and then towards your top hand grip, and the second pendulum is the pole in the halter. So both pendulum has to be coordinated each other. That means in order to have a maximize the performance, these two pendulum has to be integrated together. That means first pendulum, when the first pendulum has to fast, the second pendulum has to slow. So our main purpose is you have to make the first pendulum. Pole pendulum has to be fast by bending. The pole pendulum has to be short. Then by keeping the bolter's pendulum long, because we have to by keeping long, that means you have to loaded the about will able to about loaded the energy into the poles. Then during the beginning of the bolting action swing phase, the bolter's body should be a long pendulum, as already explained. The rotor then rotates slowly about its turning axis to maximize the pole speed. That means third pendulums, you have to our main target to you have to bend the first pendulum, make the short by bending to maximize short the pole pendulum, so that the bolter body laterally travel very fast to the off. So must be rotated quickly during the rock wave phase when the pole is slowing down, in order to complete the bolting action before the pole recoils the vertical. Before the pole come to the verticals, that means the action has to be the you have to make a position to keep your body by in a rock back position to keep your body in upside. The lower has to be up, the upper body has to be in a upside down position, because the upside has to be go back down and the lower side has to be up. So this is the physics. That means this is the two pendulum. It will be the two pendulum, and this is the pole. This is the pole is one pendulum, and the bolter is the another pendulum. So the pole pendulum is going. The pole pendulum is moving. This is the one. Is the pole pendulum is going, and it is moving from the towards the pole. So that means then it is like it is a potential energy already explained. And it is a kinetic energy coming and moving and going. If what of the double of your kinetic energy load into the pole by bending the pole, then the same amount of pole will give you to back when the pole become straight. Okay. So now this is the pole. Pole pendulum is moving and the bolter pendulum is moving. So both has to be coordinated. One is slow, the other is. If you make it fast by bending, pole pendulum make it short. So this has to be slow. So and if you have this. Has to be slow, this has to be fast by again doing a rock wave position, and this pendulum will be long because when pole become strengthening. when pole become straight, about to going near vertical straight. So pole travels, this is the pole speed. The pole travels from plant and take up to come to the vertical. That means planting should be at a 30 degree angle and it is moved from another 60 degree. It will move another 60 degree. So it is a 90 degree from the 30 degree pole moves about. So you should have a higher planting angle. If planting angle is high, you will have less time to move to the vertical. It will be fast. Now little bit about the what is the so this is about the difference between the fiberless pole vaulting and the rigid pole vaulting. If you see the rigid pole vaulting, what happens? There is here, there is no much penetration phase, and there is no bending of poles. So that's why the pole is rigid. You are not able to do the good penetration and not able to bend your energy. Now yourself has to. So athlete himself, he has to use energy from his arm and shoulder to lift the body up. But here you have to reserve the energy. Energy is stored because you still by not doing any action from your arm and shoulder, because your aim is to load the energy into the pole. Now the pole will be lift you. The pole will be lift you till the pole becomes straight. So this is the step. This is the passive phase. But here you will not get that phase. That's why this is the most advantage. Why? By doing this, we can the much benefit we are getting, we are having a good penetration phase, then we are having our height of grip, we are getting a higher grip because of the flexible nature of the pole, and of course then you can able to land load the whatever the speed you have developed, totally you have to develop, you have to load into the pole, and pole will help you to lift further, and whatever the energy, further energy we will store from your arms and shoulder, that will help you to further push your body further up when you do the push and push up phase. When you do the push up and pull push up phase, and to overcome, to then you come with the bar clearance. So it will be, and this energy can be stored and can use during here when you have a good push up. That means by doing a good push up, pull after pull. Turn, and that we can do, that utilize that time by turning, pulling, turning and push up, and have a good bar over the bar clearance. So that means main is you are having a higher grip. The because of the flexible nature of the pole, it permit the vaulters to have a higher grip. If you see the progression of the world record, the highest person jump in the metal pole is 4.80 meter, and his grip is only, he is able to hold the grip is only 3.95 meter. That means in 1960 Olympics, his name is Don Bragg from USA. He is having the highest record in metal pole, 4.80 meter. Then our first fiberglass pole started in the year 1961, and there Davis, Mr. Davis, who is the first person to use the fiberglass pole he has created a world record in 4.83. Now from the fiberglass pole from 4.83 to now it is moved to the 6.8. And our average grip is around 480 to 5 meters. World class bolter average grip. But their average grip is, so almost we are having a benefit of by changing the switchover from the metal pole to the flexible pole. That is 1 meter. But this advantage, for getting this advantage, you have to be master this technique. This bending, fiberglass bending technique. You have to master this technique. So your advantage is 1 meter. But to get that advantage, you have to master this technique. And whatever the step I told you, what the points you have to observe, that will keep in focus. So that definitely you are going to slow day by day. You are going to improve by increasing 50 centimeter, 60 centimeter, 70 centimeter. Then you can, when you reach to the peak, so automatic about at least not in the 1 meter, and you can have a benefit of about as for the level about 80 centimeters. So that is the advantage by changing. Then that the another many, but major advantage is because of the flexible nature of the pole. So we are able to gain advantage of about 80 centimeters, 1 meter. number of heights as compared to the rigid pole. So the pole selection, so this is another one criteria. That means pole selection plays an important role, because it is very important part successful bolting. Many factors influence the pole selection, including, because pole selection is depend upon your bolter's weight, grip height, hand spin, pole plant technique, takeoff speed, and of course length of the poles. So these are all contribute to select a proper pole which you are able to going to jump. The higher the bolter grip, the steeper pole. The higher the or steeper pole. That means this is the Bubka. Bubka is using a higher hand grip. That means around 5. His highest hand grip is 5.17 meters, where he has jumped is 6.114. So higher the grip, and he is steep. He is have a very steep, very strong pole. Very steep means the pole flex. So he is having a flex of 11.4, about flex number. So the higher the he is capable of jumping. That means the his fundament, his funda is, his the concept is, he was having a very good tremendous approach speed, about 10 meter per second approach velocity. Then with that he is able to have a higher hand grip and hold a steeper pole. So which is, that means the his body has to be faster by whatever the energy stored in the pole, faster his body from the energy, the pole will give back that energy very fast to lift the body up. But only thing, you have to master, you should know the what is the physics of the pole vault. So coaches should little bit develop about the physics. This is a little science. Pole vault, it is very highly, it is a biomechanical concept, has to clear. You will get all poles. Until then, if you know the knowledge, no use. Getting poles, getting all facilities, but at the side time, you have to improve your basic biomechanical aspects, what is involved in the pole vaulting to have a better job. So then the never use a pole rated below the vaulter's weight. Kabhi bhi apne aapki jo vaulter's ka body weight hai, so pole weight mein bhi wahi likha hota hai. Aapka body weight agar 60 kilo hai, pole mein bhi 60 kg hoga. Aapka body weight, then you will choose a pole of 60 kg weight. That is pole ka weight. There is no specific weight. It is related to your what aapki jo weight hai, usme pole bhi likha hoga. Length of the pole, weight of the pole. Length of the pole and the weight of the pole. That means length 4 meter, for example, 4 meter hai, usme aapki body weight bhi likha hoga. That means 50 kg, 60 kg, for example, your body weight. So you can choose that pole. And also flex number. There are three things will be written. Length of the pole, weight, pole, weight of the pole, that is pole weight, that is in equivalent to your body weight, and the flex number. Never use a pole rated below the vaulter's weight and should be equal to or exceed. That means aapki body weight ke niche koi never, kabhi bhi aapne pole choose, never choose body weight ke niche. So what happened? It may break, it may by overbending, when you do the bending, it your body weight will be more, it won't be suited to, so body will be very soft, it goes to the break, then it may go further, it may leads to the injury. So never use a pole or never use a pole rated below the vaulter's weight. Then the core should resist, because normally what happened, our pole vaulter have in habit of increasing very fast their grip height. Should not increase the grip height very fast. So core should restrict, they should not increase until unless they master the technique, until unless they develop the speed, until unless they develop the upper body strength. Okay, so what, which pole they are using, let them do that pole. Suddenly I said, okay, Bubka is doing, I'll go also. Bubka is using a pole 23 kg more than his body weight. That means his body weight was 77 and he used the pole of 100 kg body weight. That means 23 kg. But increasing that 23 kg of body weight, that means how much speed he's up, how much technicality he mastery in the technique, how much his upper body strength, all this count. So you cannot don't copy the book wise to increase the 23 kg, I will also solve. No, you should either use the pole of your own body weight, or at the most, if it is your mastery, then you see that pole is giving good bend, or whether it is not bending more than 90 degree, or it is over bending, then you can change. Then you go for the change. Then a short approach on each side always better to a grip height of 12 feet or less are recommended for learning the fundamental of pole vaulting. That means when you learn the fundamental technique, pole bending or technique, it should go for a short approach. 8 to 10 side or 8 side or less is good. And grip height should be, it's for the beginner, grip height should not be above 12 feet or should be less. Recommended for learning the fundamental. That means for the beginners. Your beginners, your grip height should not increase more than 12 feet. Grip height. And you should, or it should be less. Start from 10 feet grip height to the go for 11 feet grip height, then 12 feet grip height. So master the technique. Beginners can be used a vaulting pole of 12 to 14 feet. So 12 to 14 feet length. Length pole also should be around 12 to 14 feet length. Don't use more for the beginners. And your grip should be start from to less than 12 feet. That means the grip height between 10 to 30 centimeters from the top of the pole. That means always you should hold the pole. Your top grip should be, you should be 10 to 30 meter behind the your top end of the pole. So, aapki top end ka jo pole hai, uski 10 to 30 centimeters should be. So that you can have the proper balance, or you can proper able to bend the pole properly in a proper way. It should not be go left and right. It should be give. So you should always leave 10 to 30 centimeter from the top end of the pole. Bolters, then there is one I see that the many norms are there also, but I put some minimum norms for a bolter's performance level of 4.5 meter and above. Should you use a pole stiffness about 5 kg or higher, but agar aapki performance level 4.50 meters se niche hi hai, you should go for a pole of your own body weight. Should not increase. If the performance is you are in 4-5 meter and above up to 5 meters, then you can increase at least 5 kg. You can use the pole more than 5 kg of your body weight start, then further you can increase above minimum. You can increase 5 kg, then 6 kg, 7 kg, like keep on increasing as you develop your mastery or develop all the other parameters, developing speed, strength, technique, you can go. So in world class vaulter, use the pole more than, you know, usually 15 to 20% of their body weight. Generally, they go for 15 to 20% of their body weight. And further also, there is a limit. Further also, there is exception is there. They can go even up to, I said, Bukta has gone up to 23 kg, which is if you see his body weight 80 kg means it is goes to 16 kg, but he has gone even 23 kg. So that is excellent. But these are the general guidelines. Vaulting poles are classified by their flex number. Harek pole, harek model mein 6 flex number. Okay, the niche number hai, that is highest stiffness. Uska jo stiffness, hardness of the pole is very high. So up lowest number, more harder. Go if you the number is increasing. Agar abe 12, if your stiffness level is 12 degree, or if you are going for 20 degree, that means that pole is soft. That pole is soft, and that is suitable towards for the women's pole vault. The pole is soft. So for the male pole vaulter, your fitness, your flex number should be low. If it is okay, if Bubka is using 10.4 degree, then you go for 11 to 11.5, like to 12. So try, this is a trial and error method. So this is the guidelines. Perform safe and consistent vaulting 12 inches above the grip. So always when you do the beginners, after grip height say 2 to 12 inches, it is a safe vaulting. Apne safe. Okay. Then while keeping the crossbar 18 to 24 inches behind the vertical, that means aapki jo maximum rule permit, aapki you can go 80 centimeters towards your feet. You can penetrate, you can go. So, but in a general, that means if you go from 18, it is 45 meter, 18 centimeter, 18 inches, it is almost all 45 centimeter to 60 centimeter. If you go, we will move inside towards, if you attack inside towards the box, towards the end of the pit, it is very outstanding vertical. That means you have a very good penetration phase. That means you are thereby able to do a good penetration, do a good planting, good takeoff angle, and good approach velocity by keeping your both arm keeping forward and upward. Thereby, you are able to load the maximum energy into the pole. Our purpose is try to, because it is a bank. It is a bank. The more amount of energy load into the pole, same amount of energy will give you back to lift your pole up. Then another one's method is they are performing same vaulting means. That means I will choose a correct grip means 1.9 meter, 1.90. Suppose if you reach height, if you able to grip your grip, if you standing, if you grip height, your reach height is 7 feet. If you hold and maximum try to grip the pole by standing, keeping the pole vertical up, how much you grip? That means, for example, if you are able to 7 feet, then that means 7 feet into 1 into 90 into it. That means your hand hold should be not more than 13 feet 4 inches. And you can, with that, you can have a bolt of 13 feet 6 inches. Two, initially, you don't expect that one, that will be a big two to three feet of jump big. No, you can start. This is initially for the beginner. How you'll start? How you select the correct grip for the beginners? For the this intermediate group. That's why I've put this for the intermediate, in keeping view the intermediate groups, and little also I highlight for the elite group also. Pole length, as I already told you, pole length, pole width, flex number are considered. Flex number indicate high stiffness. जो नीचे का नंबर है वो ज्यादा हार्ड है पोल, एंड जो ऊपर का नंबर ज्यादा सॉफ्ट है. इच मॉडल हैव सिक्स डिफरेंट लेवल ऑफ स्टिफनेस. मूव टू द स्टीपर पोल व्हेन द पोल, जब आप 90 पोल बेंड्स 90 डिग्री से ज्यादा बेंड हो रहा है, देन आपने नेक्स्ट थोड़ा और ऊपर हार्ड पोल के लिए मूव करो. बाय हाउ विल इंक्रीज द स्टिफनेस पोल, आइदर इंक्रीज द लेंथ ऑफ द पोल और इंक्रीज द वेट ऑफ द पोल और इंक्रीज द फ्लेक्स नंबर. तीन एरिया है पोल को. इफ यू चूज, हाउ विल चूज वेदर द पोल इज वेरी हार्ड, दैट मीन्स either increase the length of the pole, increase the weight of the pole, and increase the flex number. But always I suggest, don't suddenly go for to increase the length of the pole. It is better to increase because it is directly related to your speed. If you increase the length of the pole, it is directly related to the speed. If you have a same, we should have a faster approach speed. But if you increase the strength of the pole, it is related to the strength. Strength in your upper body. That you can develop by doing very good gymnastic activity. Increase the by gymnastic, then wall bar, rope click, climbing. That's all. These you can have all. Then horizontal bars. Then these all things. Trampoline. You can develop this gymnastic ability. Then tumbling. That is floor exercise. These all you have to develop the upper body strength. That's why. If you see the concept of pole vaulting, you should have a good speed of a sprinters, take up of a long jumpers, of strength of a thrower, and then all coordination ability, gymnastic ability of a gymnast. All these qualities you have to see in the pole vault situation. Then lower the grip height when the we'll go back. Oh, it is gone.
Yes. Sir, yes. Just go back, sir.
Yes, sir. Now it is coming.
Yes.
Okay. Go back. Thank you for helping. Yeah. Yes. Still, we are not mastering in this offline. Online. You see, you have to learn now. No problem. You all are giving me a chance.
Yes, sir. Please.
Now we'll move to the the previous slides. Previous slides. I'll just go with the previous slides. Yeah, you. No. Just 1 second. Just give me the back. Yeah.
I'm yes, sir. Just hold on for a while, sir. Then, yeah.
Okay.
Yes. Sir.
That's good. Thank you. Election. Yes. Now, so these are the points to be keep in mind the pole selection. So now I'll go just little bit of the teaching stages. This I'll go in a hurry step because there are the teaching stages also. You should know little bit about already explained the grip and carry. That means you have to, the first stage is to grip and carry the poles. To get used the holding and running with the pole. That means from a standing position, you have to properly hold the poles. Then grip the pole by putting the pole vertically up. Try to grasp the pole as high as possible. Then from there, again, you move 20 to 30 centimeters. Then that will be the top hand grip. Then after selecting the top hand grip, then put the select the bottom grip about 50 centimeters from the top hand grips to place the pole from the towards your down. Then keep the hand close to the hips. By place the pole, the right hand should be close to the hip and start walking. But when you have a proper pole carry, then this pole carry position should be start from the walking, then from the easy running. So this I will show you. I have a video in the last proper teaching strategy how this World Athletics, they are giving the very nice video. Just if, that if subject to, if I can able to open that one. The next step, then the step into swings. Then that means after learning how to carry the poles, then move to the step into swings. This also doing from on the ground, so you can practice in the normal play fields also. That means to feel the hang and carry function of the pole. Just hold the pole above the hold height, then use three steps. Left, right, left, then do the left, right, left, then up. This three-side pattern, you fix the pole on the ground, then do the takeoff action. Takeoff from the left foot and right hand halter. This is the right hand halter. So takeoff from the left foot and land, drive free legs towards, then free legs to be take off, drive free legs to be drive upward, and then the pole has to be then pass the pole on the right side and the land on the left feet together without turning. Still, you don't turn it. You just have the feeling swing. So have the hang and carry function, feeling the hang position. Then down the step into swings. Now you need a platform. Platform should be 15 cm or 30 cm, or you can have a higher platform from that, so that you will have more time to hang. So that you will get, if you hang from, if you do the drill from a higher platform, the third step stable, then you can swing more time to hang. And but one thing, you should keep it here, your right hand should not be flexed. All the drills, your right hand should be straight. You should be keep straight your right hand. Now the left hand should be, because pole is not bending, you can have bend your left arm, but the right hand, your make sure your right hand should be always straight, right from the plant takeoff to till you start your pull and turn. So that keep in mind, that has to be straight. So while practicing also make practice. Then from the top, then use sand pit or no suitable pit. If you don't have a pit, other landing pit nahi hai, sand pit will cut. Then stand upright, get pole with extended arms. Then you stand upright, extended arms mein apne swing karna, what you learned from the previous step, and land. Then do not turn and land, sit on the mat, and or if you're mat, you can sit landing, or in a sand, or balu pit, land on the feet. Then the fourth step, swing and turn from a platform. That means the objective is to practice the swing and turn with assisted takeoff. That means from a high platform, you can swing, you can learn the swing and turn. Now you're learning swing. Earlier you learn the only swing. Now then swing and turn also. But the first phase of your swing, don't turn. If you first phase, you should have a long swing, then turn. Stand upright, grip a pole, extended arms, drive free leg forward, swing the platform, swing and turn in the second arm. So that should be in the second arm. Land on the both feet. That means don't early. You should go away. You should go away proper hang and swing. You take off and hang and swing in the first part. Second part, then you will have a swing. Second, when you enter to the second part, then you are going to have turn and landing on the both feet. Bolt over a. Then after that, you can have even over a keep on two uprights, put some elastic rope. So from the then you can hold over a low height, keep on low height by elastic rope. This action also you can do. Those action to swing, turn, and landing on the foot. This practice should practice. Then the last is we have to. Then fifth is plant and hold. Now remove the from the high platform. You do it from the you come to the run up. Then you practice. Then you do introduce a regular plant. That means from the five straight, seven straight, do the plant take off. Do the plant take off. Then swing and turn. Swing and turn, and do, you have to do the plant. Plant and vault, complete vault. Swing, turn, and land on the on your feet. Or if your mat is there, you land on the, try to land on the back. So there is no problem. Then practice the pole plant. Plant the pole from, first from the walking. The plant has to practice from the walking. Then move to the rhythm from 5 to 7 cycle approach. Then take up swing and turn. Land on the both feet. In, or if you are landing on the sand. Then the whole sequence. Now this is the whole sequence you have to do. Then better you should have a small approach runs about 10 to 12 meters. Then you do the whole acceleration, plant, take up slowly. You have to then carry the pole as per normal plant, normal and plant. Start with medium approach. That means 12 to 14 side approach, or 10 medium or 8 to 10 side approach. Then gradually increase speed, length and speed, and do the complete hold. So these are the sequence of the teaching drills. So after that, immediately, if you learn all these stages, then you have to immediately little bit your athlete able to jump little bit high. So better don't delay. Then you can start the bending technique. You can start the bending technique. There are the four stages. That the four stages. That means with the help of the coach, coach has to, that means the athlete, then pole, put the pole on the vaulting box, the fiberglass pole. One athlete will help to pull the pole towards the pit, and the coach has to assist from the back. Then try to hold and lift. So try so that thereby the athlete used to first pressure from his both arms, pull from not pull, pressurize from your both arms, so that do the bending. Then keeping both arms forward and upward. The first stage, the second stage. Now little put the pole on the 5 to 6 meters away from the vaulting box. Let the pole glide, and by running the coach has to push, and the coach has to from the back also again. Don't leave now. Don't again from the shoulder. He has to hold, and the athlete himself do the takeoff and penetration phase by pushing both the arm forward and upward. This is the second stage. Third stage also, from the, then again the athlete himself let it be sliding the pole, put the tips of the tail tips, the pole on the ground, then let it slides forward, and let it, then after little double up little speeds, and the pole will rest on the vaulting box. So again the coach has to push from the, here now the coach has to push from the back. These are the usual, most of the coaches they are doing, but still then you should don't. You must teach very early when you are teaching the children, because many young coaches they are watching. So if they want to do their career as a pole vault coach, they should be the other phase. Also, it is available in the YouTube also. There is the bending procedure. But I must say, I must suggest the technically part should not. You should know what is the IWF and World Athletics has given by doing research. The fundamental, you must develop the fundamental movements of the technique first. Then when you become elite, then you can little bit do the variation. Then third phase, this is the last phase. This is also same. The athlete has to, the coach has to push from the back. Now the athlete has to go the proper takeoff, penetration, rock back, and bar clearance. So from the short approach, then slowly you can move. But while doing this bending, you must choose the smaller length pole. Because the pole, you have minimum length of pole, you can see it is 3.05 meter. A maximum it is available pole, it is 5.30 meter. That is not more than. Now though, the poles are available. It is 3.05 meter to 5.30 meters. That is the maximum length of the pole, and minimum it is 3 meters, 0.5. About the pole. So you can choose, you can, when you're teaching for the students or beginners, go for a very short pole, very small pole, lighter pole, teach them the skills of by normal, by teaching with that they should learn the normal pole vault technique of a rigid pole, and after that once they learn the normal pole vault technique from the rigid, then they can immediately you can switch up to the fiberglass vaulting. Don't delay. It should be right from early age also you can teach, there is no problem. So you can see that video, one video I'll be sharing you now, how the Armand Duplantis has developed his career right from the age of 6. So that it will be a motivate to the all the participant, all the athletes who are watching now. So thank you very much, sir. So now my theory part is over. So I request Mr. Jayaraman to show the video.
Jesus, broke his toe.
Come on, Joe.
First call, boys and girls hurdles.
Yeah!
First call, boys and girls hurdles.
Smoked.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Thank you so much, sir, for the wonderful session on pole vault.